Outside of Canada, our winters are pictured as great frozen forests or serene landscapes where skaters and skiers glide. For farmers and hunters, it's true, but for those who have lived through a few city winters, mornings when the car wouldn't start, slushy afternoons, evenings when the furnace broke down and the plumbing burst, there's been time to wonder how we've survived. We thought of this recently when we looked up two old artist friends, Gordon Rayner and Robert Markle. They've been friends for 15 years, and there's something about the good times they have together that constitutes a kind of survival kit for the numbing Canadian winter.
Are you an Indian? I've never actually asked you that. I mean, here, it's a rumor.
Yeah, everybody has a rumor, yeah.
Are you part Indian?
Yeah.
What kind?
The most part. The best part.
The best part. What kind of Indian? What tribe?
Mohawk.
All right.
I'm one of the rare Mohawk Indians that is afraid of heights. My brother and my father, when he was alive, was a steel worker. And my brother climbs, loves it up there.
Does he?
Would rather be up there than down here. And I would rather be down here. I don't even get up there. I just know for sure that I'd rather be down here.
You don't think about being Indian? You don't identify?
No, not really. I've started to think about it now, but only in terms of maybe doing that. But I'm not really, I don't think about any of those things. You know what I mean? Not just that, what else?
Beyond immediate family, you're very close to.
Yeah, very close to my immediate family. And then that's it. Or fame. I don't think about fame.
You don't think about fame?
No, or art. I don't think about art very much either.
Do you?
I don't think about art. I think about ideas to do.
Oh, yeah, but that's your job.
Yeah, right.
You
right.
Think about your job.
Right.
Mad dog frosting at the mouth. What? Speak. What? Speak. Now, what are you going to do with it? Come here, bring it here. Let's have it, fella. Come on, bring it over here. Hey.
Me, Mike, well.
I believe in the possibility to really know. I think that you can know. I think that it's possible for a human being to capital K know. You know what I mean? Like, really understand, really have the knowledge of his own self, I suppose, and therefore everything. I think that's possible, and I think that one of the vehicles in which man uses in order to sharpen his senses or to keep refueling is art.
Jingle, jingle. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Telephoto. Want to see a telephoto? Could never keep a secret. I always telephoto.
Would you send your daughter to a school with teachers like that, sir? Oh, this is, you gotta have a picture of this. Easy Rayner. Mike Saracen cut this out and sent it to me from the back of a cereal box in California. And I just got my motorcycle.
So you'd use so it too?
Yeah. And of course the film was out. Easy Rayner. In his newfound Eastern humility, he describes himself as, all these things are true, of course. There's no exaggeration here. Naturalist, photographer, addict, father, alcoholic, passionist, percussionist, author, poet and laureate, artist, hedonist, filmist, lover, entomologist, humorist, painter, musician, viper, husband, blackguard, man, boy, colorist, gourmet, dancer, product of a broken home, sympathist, philosopher, musicologist, discographer, composer, cowboy, anecdotalist, philanthropist, beggar, fisherman, hunter, motorcyclist, brother, uncle, sculptor, sailor, lover, and liar. I'll slap this hand and the cigarette will take 8 turns and land in my mouth.
He can do it.
Thank you.
We groove together is because, in a sense, grooved, I don't like that. Why one of the reasons why we're so close, I think, is because of the enormous amount of things that we share. And normally an artist, being a very selfish, creative person, eventually has to block out his woman or his mate from a great, enormous part of his life, simply because he has to go into the studio. And even though physically I do that, I'm in there re-caressing and re-loving and redrawing and re-dealing and re-understanding. Marlene. She's also the most intelligent girl that I know on any level. I haven't met anybody who has got things together. I know people who have read more books, but not a hell of a lot more. And I certainly haven't met anybody who's more sensitive. And I haven't seen any woman that has more class. So, well, you know, what else is there?
Filming ground to a halt, while the dog was rushed to the vets in Guelph and a successful operation performed. We were reminded of Markle's accident on his motorcycle a year or two earlier. It was very serious. For a while it was thought he might die. And when he began to recover, it was rumored that only his carefully cultivated beer belly kept his liver from being punctured when the bike fell on top of him. When he got out of the hospital several months later, he moved to the farm. And over the past while, living quietly in the country, he's regained the use of his fingers while learning to play the piano. There's a sense of his having begun a new life.
I don't want you to do this in different kind of speed, so it looks like Keystone Cops. You know that stuff? Change the camera. New York directors do that. When they make NET films on all those nice. You can see those drawings, they come from those photographs, which I guess you can't look at, but that I took of Marlene. These are, can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
These are sketches of her ideas and pictures, right? Which got the whole series. And these sketches come pretty well directly from those photographs. Okay, so here's a... These are, again, for some unknown reason, I'm starting to play areas outside the figure in those things. I'm still into that. They're closer to the more hectic black and white things. It's seductive, but I really like it when splash, you don't try for them, but when splashes happen, you know, I really dig it. There's an immediacy there that in a sense isn't so, because these things are done over long periods of time, and hauling them out and going back, and for every picture here, there's at least five that have been ripped up, and you know. But so what? I mean, it's not supposed to come easy anyway, right?
Yeah.
But I like it to look as though it did. I like a picture to almost complete itself while you're looking at it. You know what I mean? Resolves itself. I do things too, like I do a picture like that and then halfway through realize that I want it like that. You know? It's going to be awkward when I attempt the Sistine Chapel ceiling. I mean, to turn it around like that. I like this one the best in a sense because I like the bulk of the body. You know what I mean? I mean, even chicks that aren't Vogue proportionate, they can look really groovy, you know. These others, well, anyway, I like to put one of those. And this is the last, okay? Again, coming directly out of one of those drawings.
Photographs,
I mean. To retire. This is the last work I've done. Except that I've been working on the painting.
Self-portrait for when I'm going to be a movie star in a cowboy movie.
In a western.
In a western, yes.
Who's your favorite?
Favorite western, Hollywood western type?
Or whatever.
Who's my favorite? Mind your own business, Charlie. Better show these to Markle. Let him know where it's at.
That's fibs, eh?
Yeah. That's Vibb's dashing. Toward herself headlong. Then she went away. She went off to visit her parents. I was up there alone. I wrote a lot of poetry. Committed suicide. It's like the other night I slashed my wrist with an electric razor. All it did was tingle. John O'Keefe returns. After 5 years, man.
Where'd he been for 5 years?
On the high seas.
Is he really a sea captain?
Mm-hmm. He's a sea everything.
Yes, sir.
The
Oh, bananas flambe. That's the second thing I thought of.
You find a very, very hot, red hot wood stove, first of all. Put a frying pan on it with a banana in it, preferably peeled. And you stand back with a quart of rum in one hand and a quart of brandy in the other. And you go, ah! And then you spend the rest of the night putting the cabin out. Jeez, if you can ever find them, are they ever delicious? Marvel at it. Not that Charlie's good.
Well, 2 days ago, I was getting all my stuff set into the cleaners before I came back up here. And I walked into this cleaning store, and what had happened in real fact is that my jacket, my corduroy jacket, which is right over there, a box of peppermints had worked itself down into the lining and was completely, my jacket was full of peppermints. Yeah. I mean, quite honestly, see? And I couldn't get it. I mean, I had peppermints inside. Yeah. I couldn't get them out. No, this is very real. But there I am suddenly, and I walk in just with that in my mind. It's perfectly
right. Yeah,
right, yes. And finally my turn comes up and says, may I help you, please? And I say, yes, my jacket's full of peppermints. And she said, oh, really? That was our torches, and there was a girl in a big gown in front of me. My aim wasn't too good, and I stuck the torch right on her dress. The dress went on fire, and as they're all singing, I'm going... They were all singing. That's where I started to sing too. I was singing my own words.
This was conceived this way, but. As a kind of scroll that you pull out. I had a man come by here who owned a used car lot, who went to school with Av Isaacs. He said, now, you see, the place over in my Chesterfield is pretty much that shape, except you got to... Now, if you'd only done it this way. So I looked at it that way, and I thought maybe it was the end of the thinnest roll of the most colorful toilet paper that ever was painted. Mm-hmm. And I looked at it that way a long time. And then I suddenly realized that what it was a painting that was falling and unrolling by its own nature. So it went that way.
Frames and frames.
A lot of my paintings, in fact, most of them. I've got two kinds. Kinds that are done in the city and completely imaginative. And in that sense, abstract, misused word, but true. And the others are from nature. They're the Charlie's paintings, and I continue to do them. This is a Charlie's painting. This is naturalistic to me. It's the rapids. It's the foreground, the rapids. It's a river. And there's a goddamn fully intended foreground in the classical sense of painting. There's the water, the middle ground, and there's the background, and there's deep space. Terribly out of fashion, you know. But it's a landscape painting, huh?
Sure is real.
That's about all I have to say about that painting. This is also that same kind of thing. It's landscape painting in a way. It's really taken from a screen door, sitting inside of a cabin, and you look out and you see that. It's naturalistic painting. But they're only the sources, you know. They're like flashbacks. You realize that, I realize that, in a sense, after they're done. What really, really matters is that they are paintings more than anything else. It's not what they remind me or you of. It's their paintings, their paintings. If you watch Star Trek too much, you start doing paintings like this. You really
does it take you to do a painting?
35 and a half years.
That's nice.
And I have in my head that I want to do something, and then my hand does what I was doing before.
Yeah, well, that's because you do things by habit, right?
Yeah. And so
I really don't understand it.
You don't understand what, the habit?
No, what you're, what you would want to do. Was that you're trying to do three things at once. You're trying to make a drawing with the color. You're trying to make the color do something in terms of form. Yeah. And also you're trying to design on the page.
That's right.
With one brush full of paint, you're trying to do all those things. You can't do it. So if you just block this thing in really quickly with something very neutral, like watering the page or a gray or anything like that. And then you can sort of say, all right, now I want the head, like the head and the left breast and the right arm are on the same plane. So I'm going to make those blue. And then you just go bang, bang, bang.
Was it you who was telling me that a friend or somebody you'd met saw his ghost?
One of the other fellas.
Saw his ghost, yeah.
Saw
Tom Thompson's ghost. He somebody who lives up there, and he paddles on Canoe Lake quite frequently, and he kept hearing somebody, a canoe, paddling alongside quite often. And then one night, through the mist, sure as hell, he saw a canoe coming toward him. And he hailed, you know, hi, or whatever you do. I don't think they say ahoy, particularly. And the guy just kept coming, came right out of the mist and went by, and it was Tom Thompson. To this day.
You kind of identify with him a bit, don't you?
Well, I like the north. I like the north.
Yeah.
I like to paint it. Yeah. See, that stuff is all mixed right on your brush. That's five different colors all on the same brush. And just right across. It's not mixing it up bit by bit. It's a bit of ochre on one side, an umber on one side, a bit of white, some pinks in there, and it's all on the same brush. And then you get all these very fine gradations all the way through in the brush marks. De Kooning does that too. Okay.
De Kooning, when he was starting off on his, I always go back to De Kooning, but he was starting off on his figure series after being a super duper action painter. And he said, well, I said, I'm going to paint the figure. And he says, I decided to make it flesh color because why not? I mean, everybody thinks it's far out to make a figure these days blue or green or orange. But I think it's further out to paint flesh color. So I'm going to paint it flesh color. And then he said, and he also said, and I stuck it right in the middle of the canvas because I really couldn't see any sense in putting it off to one side or the other. And, well, that's, don't you, I think that's really sound. I think it's beautiful.
Yes, the city certainly is an evil place.
Thank you.
I think I picked the one with the lions. What do I do now?
It's for you.
I've got a bucket of methadrine with me, man. I don't need any of that amateurs yet. We even writing TV plays about it now.
Susie, no,
man.
Listen, pal, I just finished making a movie about it. Is that what you're referring to?
Yeah. All right. Are you getting a chance to go back and shoot
more?
Yeah.
They wouldn't even give me any fucking free samples for the movie.
You mean you weren't doing it right?
No, they wouldn't let me. If you insist,
you work on that. Is that that speed film?
Yeah.
What's it like?
Quick.
No comment.
It's a very fast movie.
I don't know, I haven't seen it. Hey,
how did you feel when you were acting? Did you feel like this?
Oh, you made me drop and shit.
Well, I thought it was pretty good. Pretty much what we did in 2 weeks.
That's right.
I researched my material.
I understand you asked Gordon Rayner for a little advice.
Easy! Sound on and all that. Easy!
Yeah, right. It's not against the law.
This is going to be the drinkingest, smokingest, snortingest. But in this movie, you've ever seen, or otherwise it'd be.
Hey, you guys, come and eat, eh?
Come and eat, eh?
I really pissed off.
They'll do it when they want to. Come on, they'll
do it. Oh, no, they're trying to say.
They're trying to be nice.
You're being a friend. You're the director, you're eating.
Come and eat.
If they're doing what they want, then you should be doing it.
Come on.
Come on, Mo, let's tell some French Canadian jokes. There's one captain that won't go down with the ship, believe me. Once this film springs a leak, and there are many, he'll be the first guy to run out.
Hey, put the camera down.
Go ahead.
Cut.
Terrific. Hey, she does it.
Oh, hey, what are you doing?
Take two.
Take two.
Take two. Let's go rolling. Keep it rolling.
We
we've shown a very one-sided view of Rayner and Markle and their friends. Their lives are much more than this film could ever hope to capture. Someone over this weekend told the story of a small town in the Middle East where all the townspeople were uptight, each locked in his private grief. Then someone suggested that each bring their troubles in a bag to the center of the town and take away with them the bag they felt they could handle. For a while there was a great deal of hustle and bustle as the townspeople rushed about looking in the various bags. But at the end of the day, it was discovered that everyone had returned with their own bag. Cowboy or Indian, Gemini or Virgo, country calm or city hype, who would exchange his own for another's bag?
Went up all night with his
Dunny's
drawings.
You want to
show them to us,
Frank? Did they see drawings here? There's one drawing here. This one. Kleenex stuck to it. You'll notice how I simplified the whole thing.
Well, there's only two left, is there?
Yeah. I threw out 40.
You painted about 10 on each one.
Yeah, well, you kept coming down and saying, paint some more on them, Bob. Darn. Root.
Hey, Brad.
Must we? Yeah?
Rayner's really weird.
What do you mean?
Where's that?
All that figure painting shit.
Frozen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
My apertures have to adjust.
Who are you?
My name's Robert Markle, and this is my happy home. This is my happy goddamn wife. And I'm right looking at the happy crew. Now close the goddamn door, because I'm freezing.
Let's go.
My name is Gordon Rayner.
My name is Vibica.
Nodrog Rinyar.
Robert Barber Marver Cobble.
Gager Dagan Reganager.
Bob Yarrows of an Stubbs of another Shafanabble. Fathom Barber.
Figa Kegging Fagelms. Stegar Fagging. Fagum Hagum Gager.
My name's Harold Town. And I really am going to try better and harder. Now on.
I think you should.
He pushed me!
Yay! Say your name. Your real name.
My real name is Michael Sarrazin.
Brought to you by the makers of Robert Mark.
Close the door.
What is this, laughing? Nobby Kubota.
Thank you.
Nobuo Kubota.
Kubota-san.
My name is Graham Coffrey.
We can't fit the drums in, sorry.
Good.
Come on, we all get down there. Okay, get right up in front. Right up in front.
Never mind that
problem.
Somebody,
can you lean forward, Dobby, and I'll hang on to you?
Okay. You got me.
Lean right out and I'll hang on.
Further. What if it tears?
If it tears, you're going to fall, that's all. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Ah!
More.
Come
on.
Oh, oh,
yeah.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
oh, no. Oh, baby.
Yeah.
It's like ice. It won't turn.
Okay.
Well, should we walk off into the sunset?
Yeah. No snowmobile.
I'm Don Owen, and I directed and edited this film.
Doug Kiefer photographed it, and Jim Jones did the location sound. The assistant director was Paul Saltzman, Sandy Altwerger the assistant editor. The soundtracks were edited by Bill Graziati and re-recorded by Roger Lamoureux. Cowboy and Indian was produced by Tom Daly.